Hello and welcome. The theme of this show will be the lions in the streets of Prague. We will introduce only statues of lions. We will not deal with reliefs of lions and two-dimensional lions on national emblems and on house signs. Not even statues of lions in museums. For example, there are several ones in the lapidaries of the National Museum. We will focus only on statues of lions in the streets. First, let's introduce the inspiration. It is the lion, in Latin, Panthera leo, the second largest feline after the tiger. For our purposes, we will distinguish African lion species and the Eurasian lion. I assume you all know the African lion. We will look at three representatives. This is the Congo lion. It lives in the south of the Sahara, mainly in the dry areas. And here is a lion from the south of Africa. Here we can see the Barbary lion, which used to live in the north of Africa. Now it lives only in the zoological gardens. And in closing, the South African white lion. It is not a species, it is the result of the lack of pigment. The Eurasian lion used to be found from southern Europe to India, and today there are several hundred individuals left in the Gir Forest National Park in the West Indian state of Gujarat. This lion differs from African species in slightly smaller stature, but mainly by the longitudinal skin lobe on the abdomen and significantly smaller mane in males. When we came to the pen, the lion snored, and therefore we could not film it properly. I snuffed out the firecracker, which the cameraman was going to throw at the lion, and suggested to wait for a while. After 5 minutes of waiting, the cameraman threw a handful of sand there. The lion woke up, went for a walk through the pen, and it even had aphrodisiac effects on him. We will briefly mention the Czech lion, thus the lion from our national emblem. It is a silver two-tailed lion in a jump with a golden crown and claws in a red field. It is usually portrayed in white color, with the white color representing silver, therefore metal. Originally, the lion was a family emblem of the Przemysl dynasty. The king Przemysl Otakar II introduced it as an emblem of the Czech kingdom. The use of lion symbolism has therefore been a Czech tradition and symbol of Czech statehood since the 13th century. According to the heraldic legend, the king Przemysl Otakar I received the second tail for the lion from the emperor Otta IV in 1204 as a reward for his help against the Saxons. By adding the second tail, the lion became a supernatural animal and was therefore promoted. However, its use is documented with Przemysl Otakar II in 1247. We are in front of Prague Castle, the largest castle in the world. It was the seat of Czech kings and Czechoslovak presidents. Now it is the seat of Czech presidents. It is also one of the symbols of the Czech statehood as it has been the center of the Czech state since the end of the 9th century. Behind us, you can already see the first lion. It stands on a pillar in front of the first courtyard of the castle. The author is Ignác František Placer, and the statue is from 1768. The lion is accompanied by two angels. Lions with Cupids in the Royal Garden of Prague Castle from 1729 to 1734 are from Matyáš Bernard Braun. Along with other statues are a part of the decoration of this beautiful garden. At the northern entrance of Prague Castle, this lion from 1966 by Vincenz Makovský stands. After the damage, it was restored, and since 2009 it has been here. The lion is made of diorite. The pylon is made of granite. We are at the early Baroque fountain in the second courtyard of the Prague Castle, carved in 1686 by Francesco Bartolomeo della Torre. The sculptures were made by sculptor Jeroným Kohl, and therefore it is called the Kohl's Fountain. There are two basins on the middle leg. The lower one is supported by the Roman gods Mercury, Vulcan, Neptune, and Hercules. The upper one is carried by two tritons. The ball at the top is supported by three lions. There are four lions in the Cathedral of St. Vitus. One of them is on the tombstone of Count Leopold Schlick, which is the work of Josef Emanuel Fischer from Erlach, František Maximilián Kaňka, and Matyáš Bernard Braun. He lies on a marble pedestal and holds a broken sword in his right front paw. The other three lions are in the St. Wenceslas Chapel. They are made of white marble. They sit on the hind legs and with the front paws hold a horn, which has the function of a pedestal for a candle. In the garden na Valech, on the south side of the Prague Castle, which was adapted according to the plans of Josip Plečník, in front of the Bellevue Pavilion, from the first half of the 20th century, there is the so-called Hercules Fountain from 1923. It includes an early Baroque sandstone statue of Hercules from the 17th century. The hero opens the lion's mouth, from which water flows into the basin. We are in the courtyard of Strahov Monastery, where this bronze lion from 1936 by sculptor Bohumil Kafka stands. In the garden of Kinsky under the Petrine Hill, there is Hercules fighting with a lion in an artificial pond. Now we are in Chodkova Street near this sandstone statue of the Czech lion from 1852 by Josef Max. It was created in honor of fallen soldiers during the campaign to Italy in 1848. Originally it stood on the New Town walls, then in Poříčí Park, and ended up here. The Winged Lion Monument on Klárov by the British sculptor Colin Spofforth is dedicated to Czechoslovak airmen who fought in the British Royal Air Force during World War II. It is a gift of Britons living in Czechia and Slovakia. The lion is made of bronze. On the plaque there are 2,507 names of Czechoslovak RAF personnel. We are in front of the Chamber of Deputies of the Parliament of the Czech Republic now, which is housed in the Tunovský Palace. The original buildings were rebuilt in Baroque style at the turn of the 17th and 18th century, and subsequently there was a classicist reconstruction at the beginning of the 19th century. In the southern part of the building there is a Baroque fountain with a lying lion as a gargoyle, which is from later times. In the north-placed atrium, there is a statue of Veit by Stanislav Hanzík, where we can see the Czech lion. On the stone wall, there are alternate motifs of the Czech lion and the eagle of St. Wenceslas, also by Hanzík. In Nerudova Street, there is an allegory of four continents on the attic of the facade of the Morzinski Palace. Third from the left is America, with a lion at its feet. It dates from the end of the 17th century, probably from Ferdinand Maximilian Brokoff. The lesser town bridge tower is made of three parts. The oldest one is the tower of Judith Bridge from the 12th century, which was reconstructed in the Renaissance style in the 16th century. The gate was built by King Wenceslas IV in the 14th century. The higher tower was built under King Jiří z Poděbrad in 1464. The lion is on the right console of the eastern facade of the gate between the smaller and larger tower. We continue to the Charles Bridge, which we probably do not have to introduce to anyone. It is a Gothic bridge from the 14th century. A pride of lions is at the statue of St. Vitus by Ferdinand Maximilian Brokoff from 1714. Another lion accompanies the Knight Brunswick. In fact, it was a border stone that symbolized how far the rights of the old town go. The original sculptural group was made by Matyáš Rejsek in the 15th century. However, it was damaged by artillery fire in 1648. In 1884, it was replaced by a sculptural group made by Ludvík Šimek. The lion on the Gothic Old Town Bridge Tower from the end of the 14th century is from Petr Parleš. It is on the eastern facade of the tower above the heads of the monarchs. On the left console there is another lion which eats a leg. There are other lions on the western facade. On the left console there is a lion which is fighting with a snake, and on the right console there is a lion which is fighting with an eagle. At the city emblem there is a relief of lions. On the corner of the old town square and small square there is the house Uminuty. It is a late Gothic building that was rebuilt in the Renaissance style. At the end of the 18th century there was a pharmacy at the White Lion, and since then there is this lion. There is another lion a few meters away, but it is not a statue. It is this flat lion from the 17th century on the fountain in the small square. Two lions are on the Old Town Square, on the gable of the former Prague Municipal Insurance Company from the turn of the 19th and 20th centuries, built according to the project of Oswald Polívka. The lions come from sculptors Bedřich Šimonovský, Eduard Picard and František Kraumann. There are two lions at the side entrance to Rudolfinum. It is a neo-Renaissance building by architects Josef Zítek and Josef Schulz. Two lions made of coarse-grained sandstone by sculptor Bohuslav Šnirch stand in front of the side facade to the 17th November Street. At the circular fountain in front of Karolinum, one of the buildings of the Charles University, there are three lions in a jump from grey-blue granite from 1975 by sculptor Stanislav Hanzík. On the facade of the Old Town Market Hall from 1893 in Rytířská Street, there are two lions holding the city signs. They are the work of Emil Ficker. A pair of lions is on the corner of the house at Two Red Lions in Rytířská Street. Lions are wooden on a late classicist house. On the facade of St. Havel's Church, there is a statue of St. Elisha, probably from the workshop of Matouš Václav Jekl from the beginning of the 18th century. There is a lion sitting at his feet. In Celetná Street, by the staircase, to the theatre hall, there is a wooden statue of Hercules fighting with a lion. The authorship is unclear. The work was created in the 16th to the 18th centuries. On the western facade of the Powder Tower, we can find two lions in the relief, and near them there are two lion statues on the consoles. On the eastern facade there are other two lions. We are in front of the Czech National Bank in Na Příkopě Street. It is a neoclassicist building of the trade bank from the second half of the 1930s by František Rojt. On the elevated prism there is a bronze statue of Genius with a lion from 1898 by Antonín Pop. In the entrance hall of the Academy of Sciences of the Czech Republic from the second half of the 19th century there are two bronze lions by Josef Václav Myslbek from 1896 and 1898. They stand on the landing on the sides of the staircase. They have the front leg on a sphere with the diameter of 25 centimeters. A pair of lions stand in the courtyard of the Rococo Pachtův Palace from the 1860s. We are now at the Minor Theatre, in the passageway by the staircase to the small scene. There is this lion made of coarse-grained sandstone. The origin is unknown. We are at Vyšehrad, in front of the early Baroque Leopold Gate from the second half of the 17th century. It was built by Carlo Lurago. There are disputes about the author of the decoration. There is talk of Giovanni Battista Alio or Giacomo Passarini. On the plinth, on the sides of the gate, there are lying lions. At Vyšehrad railway station, there was a statue of a lion. It is a building in Art Nouveau style, which is a cultural monument. In 2007, the Czech Railways sold it to an investor from the West, perhaps an American one. But the ownership structure is very complex and unclear. The station is in a very dilapidated state today. The statue of the lion was created at the turn of the 1940s and 1950s by a stonemason workshop under the Nuselský bridge. Today the lion is located in the art garden under the Nuselský bridge. It is a statue of a walking lion. In this unique place we found another three lions from the same pack. The fifth one is in Holešovice in Železničářů Street. In the art garden there is a small lion which cannot be missing in our video. In Holešovice in Železničářů Street there is a lion from 2002 in front of the Omega Terraco building. We are in Anglická Street. There is a lion which sits on its hind legs on the corner of one of the buildings. In Davidce in Navlčovce Street there is a lion at one of the houses. Allegedly there were originally two from around 1930. On Letenská Square on the building of the Ministry of the Interior there is this lion holding the city emblem with its paw. It is a part of the memorial to the May Uprising. Now we are in Troja, near the zoo. There is a memorial to the victims of the First and Second World War from Troja by sculptor Jan Straka, which includes this majestically standing bronze lion. We are on the southern edge of Prague, in Kunratice. This lion is a part of a sandstone monument to the fallen in World War I. It is the work of the sculptor A. Hloušek from 1922. In the marketplace Sapa, there are some lions as well. Two lions are at the southern gate. Two lions are at the western gate. And another two lions are in the compound. These two lions stand on the pillars of the gate in Klánovice. We assume that there are many more such garden lions which stand in the gardens, on staircases and fences of Prague houses. But we are not able to find and film all of them. Thank you for your attention, and if you want to see Prague from a different point of view, follow the lions.